In this illustration, we'll demonstrate you the boundary charges at the junction of conductors. Here we are given the two cylindrical conductors with equal cross section and different resistivity, rho 1 and rho 2 are put end to end. And we are required to find the charge at the boundary of the conductors if a current I flows from conductor 1 to 2. Here, if I draw the situation, you can see these are two conductors which are joined end to end. These are 1 and 2. And a current I is flowing through the two conductors as they are in series. The current remains same. Here, we are required to find the charges appearing at the boundary if the resistivity are rho 1 and rho 2. Here, due to difference in resistivity, some charges will be collected or accumulated here at the junction. We are required to find it. For this, we apply Gauss law on this small surface and we name the surface as M. So, here we can write, we apply Gauss's law on closed surface M. As in the situation, say this is a point in conductor 1 where electric field is considered to be E1. Because we know the direction of electric field is along the direction of current or current density, and the value of electric field we know it is also given as rho j or it is rho I by A if rho is the resistivity and j is the current density. Then in this situation, if electric field in conductor 2 is considered to be E2, then here we can write, applying Gauss law on the surface M, through its lateral surface no electric flux is there. And here we can write E2 multiplied by S. If S is the cross-sectional area of this conductor, we consider its cross-sectional area to be S. Then E2S is the flux which is coming out minus E1S is the flux which is getting into the surface M. And this can be written as QB, that is the charges appearing on this boundary, which I can denote as QB divided by epsilon. In this situation, the value of electric field E2, here electric field in conductor 2, we can write as density. This can be written as resistivity rho 2 multiplied by the current density, that is I by A, or it is I by S. Here I am taking A or S as same, multiplied by S I can substitute as A, minus E1 I can substitute as rho 1 multiplied by current density, this is again I by A, and here it is multiplied by A, that is equals to QB by epsilon 1. Here this area I am taking as A only. So here this A gets cancelled out and you can see the value of boundary charges we are getting. This is rho 2 minus rho 1 multiplied by I epsilon 0. That is the result of this problem. The charges accumulating at the boundary of two conductors connected in series which are having different resistivity.